Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Ajan Reginald, the CEO of Roquefort Therapeutics. Ajan, great to see you again. It's not been long since our last update. So what's this morning's news?
Yeah, good morning again, Thomas. Yes. So we're announcing we've developed an mRNA platform, which is our fifth anti-cancer platform. mRNA is a very exciting technology, something that was accelerated by the mRNA vaccines. But something that was always sort of intended to be focused on cancer. The leaders in the field are companies that we've heard of, Moderna and BioNTech and others. And mRNA is another way, a different way of attacking cancer. And it fits us very well, both from a strategic perspective and from a patient focus, as well as a commercial perspective, because mRNA is a highly innovative method to kill cancer. And that's really, as we've talked about before, that's really what Roquefort Therapeutics is about. We're about developing cutting edge medicines using innovative new approaches and innovative new targets. So this fits us very well.
Understood. So what will be the function of this new platform?
So, the function of all of our platforms is to develop medicines that treat the most difficult cancers, the cancers where patients, unfortunately, even after all these years of cancer research and billions of dollars, where there are still some patients who unfortunately have a very poor prognosis. Patients who whose type of cancer means that only 30% of patients are still alive after 10 years. So that's where our focus is. So this new mRNA platform allows us to develop medicines against these very difficult to treat cancers. We've got four different mRNAs in the family, and we're moving forward now with testing those against these very difficult to treat cancers.
Understood. So how have investors taken the news so far, do you think?
So there's been a lot of interest. People are asking kind of, what are you doing? Why are you looking at mRNA? Which I think is a great question. I suppose for me, two things to highlight. One is this is an internal program. So this is something that our fantastic scientists have been able to produce in-house using our existing resources within budget and on schedule. So it really complements well our ability to select great innovation from outside. By looking at the outside environment, we can map very carefully where the landscape is, where are all these great innovations and what are the hot areas? There was a recent deal done with Moderna, where Moderna and Merck have put together a collaboration, and that's $250 million collaboration with Moderna. So this is a really innovative, a hot area. The second part of this is that we're able to pick the best way to kill cancer. By having a set of tools, what we're able to do is hopefully bring better options to patients. We're not stuck with one particular modality. We're able to say, in our experience, this is the best way to kill this type of cancer. And that means, I think, that we can progress programs much more quickly and reach that value inflection point where, we're looking for partners or potential acquirers.
You really are building up quite a portfolio at the moment, aren't you?
The innovation engine is unprecedented. Yes, we're delighted that our team is able to focus on delivering milestones. So not only are they delivering the milestones with the existing products, but yes, we can fit this new product very neatly into that process. So let me just explain that for a moment. So the mRNA fits extremely well with our existing oligo program. That program is already in development at one of the leading academic institutions, cancer research institutions. So this is a very small addition, but what that allows us to do is to have multiple shots on goal. And for an early innovation company like us, that's really important. The more shots we can put on goal for our patients, our future patients, and for our shareholders, the better. And if we can do that with the existing resources, I think that gives us a better chance of delivering value for shareholders and value for all of our stakeholders.
All right. Well, let me wish you the very best of luck with it, Ajan. And thank you very much for coming back to talk to us at Proactive today.
Pleasure. Thank you.